For those of you that don't know me, I'm Tom Gray, a fitness coach and personal trainer at Christchurch Sport and Active Health. Hello, Jill. Good to see people can hear me and people are interacting. That's fantastic. It means I'm not talking to a camera, which is always really nice. So as I said, I'm Tom Gray, a fitness coach and personal trainer at Christchurch Sport and Active Health. Today's class is HIIT and Abs. What it's going to involve is periods of high intensity work interspersed with recovery periods. For those of you guys that haven't been to a Christchurch Sport and Active class, a health class before, we're just going to hang around a couple of minutes just to give people a chance to join in. In terms of what we're going to need for equipment today, just your body weight and a water bottle. We're going to mainly focus on leg-based exercises, so things that involve jumping, stepping, and also squatting and lunging. So if any of you guys find things a little bit too challenging, there'll always be a regression exercise given to you, and feel free to adopt an appropriate exercise of your choice that you've done in other classes. I hope that I can match what Kaz usually does in her classes. She always does a great job. I've looked through quite a few of her classes and worked quite closely with her at the sports centre. So I hope I can bring a little bit of a different spin for you guys today, but also give you a workout that you all enjoy. Hi, Shanti. That's good to see another camera on. Fantastic. Let me just bring this a bit bigger. Hello, Gillian. You all right? Good to see you. Let me bring that round. I know Kaz talks a lot about the importance of having your cameras on, guys. Feel free as well, if you're comfortable, put your cameras on. It's fantastic. That way I can see your technique, interact with you guys a little bit more, and watch to see whether you're doing the exercises correctly. If you do have your camera on and do feel comfortable doing that, make sure you stand side on when you're doing your exercises, because if you're standing front on, I can't really see too much into your technique. So if you stand side on, that allows me to look at things a little bit more in depth. As I said, so it's HIIT today. So it's periods of high intensity work interspersed with periods of recovery. What we're going to do is we're going to work our way up. So to start with, I'm going to give you one exercise for 30 seconds. I'm then going to add another exercise. We're going to do both the exercises for 30 seconds each. I'm then going to add another exercise, 30 seconds each. And we're going to keep building it up like that. I tried it a few weeks ago when I last took HIIT, and I think it worked really nicely and got you guys a good workout. It's also quite different to what Kaz offers. So I hope it kind of mixes things up a little bit as well. We're also going to do some abs at the end. So when we get a chance, we'll do a little bit of abs and upper body, because the kind of HIIT training that we've got is mainly focused around the legs today. But the exercise is more dynamic, which is nice, and that's kind of why I've done it that way. I said, any questions at all, guys, please feel free to drop a message. Hi, Paul, good to see you. Paul's had his camera on. Fantastic. Okay, so let's start with a warm-up. So I'm going to put some music on to begin with. Fantastic. So find yourselves a nice big space for me, guys. We're going to start off very gently jogging on the spot, using the arms and the legs. Okay, we don't want to be jogging like this, so arms should be moving as well. Mainly going to focus on warming the legs through, guys. What I'm going to do to start is we're going to squat to one side, come up and squat to the other side. And we're going to do 5 on each side for a total of 10 reps. Keep that posture good, shoulders back, core tight when you squat in terms of squat technique. And when you've finished your 10 side squats, we're going to go back to jogging on the spot so I can see that you're done. We're going to go arms to our sides. More circles going forwards for me. And let's make those circles bigger. And all the way around. And swinging them across the body. And back to jogging on the spot. Next one is going to link quite nicely what we're doing today. So we're going to lunge back, down, and come through. Balance on one leg. Change sides. So 5 on each leg for a total of 10 reps. Stuff. And again, when you've done your 10, guys, I want you to jog on the spot for me. No, you're ready for the next one. Okay, we're going to come down, feet outside, shoulder width, into a nice deep core squat, shoulders back, core tight, keeping that position. We're going to move very gently from side to side. Really like to open with a pause squat. Open up the hips. We're going to go forwards and back. And we're going to go up and down very gently. So little pulses. And we're going to push up and go back to jogging on the spot. So next bit, we're going to bring the speed up to a fast run or a sprint. Okay, but look to bring the speed up from where we're at now. We're going to do it for 10 seconds. In 3, 2, 1. Bring the speed up using the arms and the legs. Fantastic. Come on, guys. Keep it going. And back to jogging on the spot for me. Okay, what we're going to do now, we're going to walk our hands down to the floor. Come up into a push-up position hold, keeping the core nice and tight. We're going to reach in and then reach all the way out. Reaching in and all the way out. We're doing 5 on each side just to warm the core up and the upper body. Of course, when you've done 5 on one side, we'll change to the other side. When we've done that, we're going to come back into that push-up position. So I know that you're all ready. We're going to come onto our knees next. Hands stay flat. Elbows come down to the ground and come up. It's a tricep extension. We're not doing a kneeling push-up. Okay, elbows are coming down to the ground and then up. Good work, guys. Well done. Okay. Jump yourselves up for me, guys. Well done. That's the warm-up complete. So as I said, we're going to go straight away. 30 seconds per exercise. Exercise number one is nice and simple. It's 30 seconds of star jumps. If that's uncomfortable, you've got knee problems, anything like that, 30 seconds of alternate step jacks. So they're your two options. We're doing 30 seconds of this. When you're ready in 3, 2, 1, let's go. No messing about today, guys. We've got a lot to get through. But if you've got any questions, though, drop them in the chat. I can see them from here. So I'll do my best to get back to you. Good stuff. Make it really dynamic as well for me, guys. I said 30 seconds. Okay, stop there for me. Next one, we did it in the warm-up. We are running on the spot, nice and fast, using the arms and the legs. So 30 seconds of star jumps, followed by 30 seconds of fast running on the spot. We've got another 10 seconds rest until we're gonna go. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So star jumps to begin. Come on, guys. Fantastic work. 15 seconds in. 15 seconds to go. If you start to fatigue, you can always go into that step jack. And straight into that running on the spot for me, guys, using the arms and the legs. As fast as you can. Come on. 30 seconds. Good work. Using the arms for me, Gillian. Good work. Come on, guys. 15 seconds to go. Feels like a lot longer when you're doing it. Come on. Okay, and stop there for me. Next one we're going to do, have a little rest. We've got 30 seconds. Is either going to be you're strong and you've done them before. A jump lunge, okay? Or we're gonna go like we did in the warm-up. Alternate reverse lunges. So star jumps, running on the spot. Jump lunge or alternate reverse lunge. In 3, 2, 1, Let's go. Come on, guys. Got his legs nice and wide. A bit more of the glutes, the adductors. Another 10 seconds to go on this one. Good shanty, well done. Keep it going, guys. And into running on the spot, using the arms and the legs. Okay, it's gonna get hard when we go into this lunge, guys. Come on. You've got 20 seconds to go, keep it going, keep it going. Good, Jessica, well done. Come on, Katie, using those arms. Okay, straight into our jump lunge or our reverse lunge. Come on, guys, keep it going. Good stuff. Alternate in between. We have 10 seconds to go on this one. I'm sorry about the next two exercises coming. They're going to be tough. And stop there. Have 30 seconds. So, next ones. Squat pulse. Bottom portion. Okay. So, feet outside, shoulder width. Core tight, head up. Hips come back. Pulsing at the bottom. So, it is star jump. Running on the spot. Reverse lunge. Squat pulse in 3, 2, 1, let's go, guys. And if you struggle with the star jumps, step jacks are fantastic. Feel free to also add a little knee bend as well. So make it into a squat in a way. Come on. Good stuff. Come on, guys. Good, Jessica, well done. Into running on the spot for me, using the arms and the legs. Come on. Reach on those arms. Keep it going, guys. We've got 15 seconds to go. Okay, we're going to jump lunges now. Come on, guys. Ten seconds to go. You're struggling. Go into that reverse lunge. You step through. Good work. And we're going to come into squat pulse. Feet outside, shoulder width, shoulders back. Pulsing through for 30 seconds. Come on, guys. Feel the legs burning a little bit now. Keep it there. Ten seconds to go on this one. And stop there, 30 seconds rest. Good work. Next one, to burn the legs out even more, we're gonna come into a pause squat. So when we finished our pulses, we're just holding that bottom portion. If you do struggle, you can always squat a little bit higher. You don't have to go the full depth if it's really hard. So just bend your legs. You will feel it in your quads, trust me. 5 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1, let's go. And let's make this into a step jack now, guys. So let's all of us go step jacks. Add in the knee bend. Make it more quad focused. Good stuff. Come on. 10 seconds to go on this one. Good work. And into running on the spot. Come on. Nice and quick. Explosive. It's only going to be as hard as you guys make it. Keep it going. 5 seconds to go. Good. Into the reverse lunge or the jump lunge. Oh, Matt seems to be running away. Come on, guys. Okay, feet outside, shoulder width. Coming down. Squat pulses for me. Bottom portion. Keep that there. Come on, guys. I feel that burn now. Struggling, as I said. A bit higher up will help. 10 seconds to go. And then we're holding the pause squat. If you want to challenge yourself, don't come up, just keep it there. 3, 2, 1. Still for me, guys. Keep that position, come on. Keep it there. Good. We have 20 seconds to go. Shoulders back, core tight. I'll give you a little bit more rest after this one. But keep it going. 10 seconds to go, come on. 3, 2, 1. Good. Take 45 seconds rest on this one. Nice work. Next one we're adding is a broad jump. So jumping forwards, stepping back. Okay, so for the first one, we're not going to do star jumps. We're now going to do side squat. Okay, because we're adding more jumping movements in. So, broad jump, forwards, step back. When you step back, try and make it dynamic. So stepping back nice and quickly. Have some water if you need, guys. We have 10 seconds to go. So we're going again. Taking in the oxygen, nice deep breaths. Come on. Okay, are we ready? 3, 2, 1. Side squats for me. Good work. Ten seconds to go until we're going to our sprinting on the spot. Now we've had a bit more rest, see if you can run faster. Okay, and into our running on the spot now for me, guys. As fast as you can. Come on. Keep it going. Get those knees nice and high. 10 seconds to go. And into our jump lunge. Or reverse lunge. Come on, guys. Ten seconds to go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Squat pulses, feet outside, shoulder width. Coming down. Get into that position for me, guys. Fantastic. Come on. Four legs when you're gonna have to jump after this, eh? Well done. Have a look at the camera. Keep there for me, guys. Good Shanti. Come on, Jessica. Well done, Kate. Keep those shoulders back for me, Kate. Good stuff. Okay, hold. Still for me now, guys. Struggling, you can always, as I said, bring it a little bit higher. Got 20 seconds to go. Got 10 seconds to go. We're coming up. Broad jump and step back for me. Jumping forwards, bending the legs, stepping back. forwards and then retreating back. Come on, guys. Make sure when you land, you bend your legs. You don't want to land with straight legs. Also, make sure that your knees are always driven out. You don't want them to be buckling in. Okay? 5 seconds to go. And stop there, well done. Good stuff. Okay, 45 seconds. We're gonna do one more round before we go into some ab work to finish off. Final round, we're gonna add burpees. Okay, so a burpee. I didn't get you doing it from the start, which is nice. I was gonna put them as the first exercise, but you would have had to do 8 rounds, which would not be fun. So burpee is down, feet come out, feet come in, and up. Okay, so it's a combination of a squat thrust and a star jump. We're gonna do 30 seconds of that at the end. So we're gonna start off with our side squats. Got 10 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1. Side squats for me, everyone. Good work. Come on. Keep it going. Ten seconds to go. Good work. Okay, into running on the spot for me now, guys. Using the arms and the legs. Come on. Driving through. We got the hard one next. We got jump lunges. Keep it going, guys. Okay, into jump lunges for me. Keep it going. Keep your shoulders back. Core nice and tight. If you can, try and control the way down a little bit. Basically, on this one, you want to avoid hitting your knees on the floor, okay? Three, two, one. Squat pulses. Come on, guys, last bit of work. Don't want to see anyone stopping. Keep it there. Come on, Gillian. Come on, Jessica, we got this. 15 seconds to go. Okay, and hold still. As I said, if you struggle, a little bit higher. Come on, guys. Quads should be on fire now. Keep it there. I don't see anyone stopping. Come on. 20 seconds to go. Last 10. 4, 3, 2, 1. Up. Good. Broad jumps. Step back for me. 30 seconds. Come on, guys. And we got burpees to burn us out. Come on. Make sure you bend your legs when you hit that landing. Keep going, guys. Come on. 15 seconds to go. Come on, Jessica. Good, Gillian. Well done, everyone. You're doing fantastically. Come on, Kate, get that jump. Good. And burpees for me, guys, to finish. Let's go. Come on. Jumping nice and high. Legs out, legs in, and up, keeping your core nice and tight. Ten seconds to go. 3, 2, 1. Grab yourselves a drink. Well done, guys. So again, we're going to take 45. Good stuff. Absolutely knackered. haven't done HIIT in a while. Well done, guys. So, core. I'm going to show you the circuit while you're resting. Exercise number one, like we did in the warm-up, is a push-up position hold. Core nice and tight. Hands under elbows, elbows under shoulders. We're then going into a plank, okay? So you can also call the push-up position hold a high plank. This is a low plank. Core tight, keep that position there. We're then going into crunches, keeping the core nice and tight, pushing the pelvis backwards. Leg raises, and then a leg raise hold. I'll remind you as we go along, it's 30 seconds per exercise. So if everyone can get down onto their mats now, we're gonna start off with our push-up position hold. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Come on, guys. So push-up position hold for me if you're not already there. Good, Kate, well done. Good, Jillian. Keep it there. Hands on the elbows, elbows on the shoulders. What you don't want is the hips to dip. You also don't want them too high. We're gonna come down onto our elbows into a plank. Still keeping that core tight. Don't let the hips dip. Come on, guys. Ten seconds to go. We're going to come down. We're going to come onto our backs. We're going to go into crunches, squeezing the core. Slow down. I like to work on pushing our pelvis in to close the gap underneath our lower back before we initiate each crunch. Really try and close that gap or that arch under your lower back. You'll feel it a lot more in your core as opposed to your hip flexors. Good. Come on, guys. Last bit of work. Hands under your bum. We're going to lift the legs up, crunch at the top, slow down for leg raise. Come on, guys. Good. Fifteen seconds to go on leg raise before we go into leg raise hold. If you're struggling, you can always bend your knees. Leg raise hold for me now, guys. Keep that there, come on. Last 30 seconds before we go into our cool down. Come on, guys. 15 seconds to go. Ten seconds to go. Four, three, two, one. Well done, guys. We're gonna stay on our mat for the cool down, so stay on your mat for me. I'm gonna pause the music. As I said, we're gonna spend a bit of time doing some gentle stretching. Well done. Fantastic work, guys. I haven't done a HIIT class in a while, so let me know what you thought. I hope you've enjoyed it, today's session. So to begin, have our hands down on the floor in like a push-up position on our knees. So we can all get onto our fronts, please, guys. Shanti's having a proper doss there after that. Well done. Good stuff. We're gonna push the hips down. Allow your core to stretch. You'll probably feel that after doing that leg raise hold, because I know I do. Good stuff. And we're gonna push our hips back, elbows down towards the ground to stretch out the shoulders. Taking a nice deep breath, breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Coming through, hips to the ground. This time we're gonna look over our shoulders to rotate at the core. And again, pushing hips back. Stretch the shoulders, making sure we're keeping that breathing. Okay, we're going to stand up, work on the legs. So standing up for me, guys. Standing on one leg, use a wall for support or objects around you if you need. Grab the foot, pull it up towards the bum, knee pointing towards the ground, hips in a neutral position to stretch out the quads in the front of the legs. We're going to pull the foot and allow the knee to come back to open up the hips. And we're allowed to come down, and we're going to change sides. Fantastic work today, guys. We all did really well. Didn't see anyone stopping, which is really good to see. Everyone just got through it. Pull the foot, allow the knee to come back. Allow it to come down. Good. Reaching down towards the toes, having the legs nice and straight. Stretch the hamstrings in the back of the legs. You'll have to know, but let me know what you guys have been up to, what you've been doing for training. Are you still at home training? I know things have gone back to normal now, but it's interesting to see what people are still doing, whether they're back training in gyms, playing sports, or they're just doing all their training still from home. We're going to come up, hands on the hips, reach back to stretch out the lower back. I think it's nice now having a mixture of home and training at the gym. And again, legs nice and straight. Try and get a little bit further for me this time if you can. And we're coming up, hands on the hips, and reaching back. And that is today's class. Well done, guys. Give yourselves a pat on the back. Have a drink of water. Thank you all so much for attending. I hope you've enjoyed. I hope I've also been able to put a different spin on things today. And the structure was a bit, you know, shocked you guys a little bit and changed things up. So I'm going to hang around at the end to answer any questions. So if you've got anything to say, just please let me know. Thank you for watching our class. Please go and subscribe to our YouTube channel and go and check out our other videos. Have a lovely day, guys. I'll be back in 5-6 weeks for HIIT Abs. When Kaz works weekends, I come in and cover her classes. So it'll be nice to have a bit of variation. Myself lost my Tuesday morning class. So it's nice to kind of mix things up and still come along. All right. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a lovely day.